So, Alan, good evening to you, sir. I mean, the conversation, the row over whether President Zelensky can speak at the Eurovision Song Contest is probably the last thing organisers needed right now.
Yeah, look, let's be honest, it's not a debate they want to be having. Eurovision's always pushing back on the idea it is political, but some would argue making this decision itself is a political act. They want the focus to be on this. Look at this behind me. Thousands of people in Liverpool ahead of the grand final of Eurovision on Saturday. They've really tried to mix Ukrainian and British culture at this event, and they won't want that overshadowed. When they won Eurovision last year, the band Kalush Orchestra ended their performance with a plea to support their country. But this year, with Liverpool hosting on behalf of Ukraine, there will be no similar statement from the country's president. We think President Zelensky would have liked to have said thank you to the British people for hosting Eurovision, they say. Liverpool has shown lots of Ukrainian attributes. The move stopping Volodymyr Zelensky speaking at tomorrow's grand final has been criticised by Rishi Sunak, but the EBU, which organises Eurovision, has stood firm, saying one of the cornerstones of the contest is the non-political nature of the event. This principle prohibits the possibility of making political or similar statements as part of the contest. That's not how those in Ukraine feel.